everyone. Oh my god. I know, I've got a beard. Can we just take a minute to like appreciate this? Like, it was so out of the blue. Everyone was like, you should totally do it. You should totally do it. And I've done it. Now, I'm really sorry that I haven't posted in a while. It's literally been a month since I've actually done any sort of YouTube videos. I have recorded a few and then just been like, not that bothered. But I'm back. It's been such a busy month since Easter. It's literally been so busy with coursework, deadlines, you name it. I've been so busy. But I'm back today because I just wanted to do something really out of the blue. I wear makeup. It's not a big deal. And I think it's a social thing. I think a lot of straight guys are very fixated that they have to have this masculinity, but in fairness, a lot of guys wear makeup. Men actually started wearing makeup before women did. So you've just got to think, and we also started wearing high heels before women did. It was a sign of power, sign of wealth, and it demonstrated that you were on the trend, which has, you know, come to fruition in the future right now. Anyway, off the history lesson, I'm here today because I want to give you guys out there, whether you're a girl, a guy, whatever, I want to give you some of my makeup tips because I've come to love makeup. You know, I've had loads of friends in the past, especially girlfriends, that have been like, oh, I really, really want to try this out and stuff, and I was never too sure. Obviously, growing up on stage, I used to wear stage makeup, but I'm not being funny, I did look like a tangerine. Now this is, I think it's $5.99, and it is, I have to say, the advantage of this is it gives your skin a really natural, really, really natural tone. So the Touch Foundation comes with a little stick that you just pull out. It's a very, very, wet foundation. It is. A lot of foundations are wet, but this one literally looks like liquid. If I just show you, there you are. And you just literally, like, I've got Real Technique brushes. You can buy similar ones, you know, it depends really what you want to do, if you want to spend more money or not. From there, you just start dabbing it into the skin. And so, and look at it. It's insane. It doesn't even look like my skin colour has changed whatsoever. It's really complimenting the skin itself. You know, just brushing my hand. The next one I'm going to talk to you about, and a lot of people will have, is MAC. MAC is a foundation that I've been using for a couple of years now. I would suggest to go, you know, if you want to just start with the high street and then work your way into brands. MAC was one of the first sort of cosmetic brands that I actually ever bought. I don't buy a lot of MAC because I know they test on animals and I don't really agree with it. So I know that is a massive thing in China, that every product has to be tested on an animal, but I do believe that it's not the right thing to do. So this one is a lot drier than the previous one. My skin tone for each one actually is varied. Like, this one's a bit darker than the other one. This one is kind of like a dab. You don't need a lot of it, but it's brilliant. So if I just start dabbing it, and then just dabbing it across my skin like so, each of them are really, really natural. Like, I don't want to go for something that makes me look too dark or too pale, just because it's just really just my skin tone. It's just a nightmare. Also, I use a brush when I'm putting it on, when I'm applying the foundation. I do use sponges, but I feel like it just caters like your skin in this like thickness. So you just kind of want it to like, not dry out, but you want it so it doesn't look like you're wearing it too much. My third and final foundation is actually a powder foundation. And this is by Nicola Roberts, one of my faves. And you can buy it on Amazon, and it's actually really, really cheap. And it's really, it's really cute actually. And yeah, you just really apply it as so, and it gives your skin quite just this like natural touch. It doesn't make it any darker or anything. It's really catering to your skin, and that's what she wanted to do with the foundation and her makeup line, was to make a line that catered for people with pale skin. And it really does work. Like, you might not be able to see it on here, but I will post results on my Instagram later, because I tell you what, it has been a godsend. For people like me, it's really worked, and I suggest anyone with really pale skin, just go on Amazon. This was $3.99. Like, this was brilliant. So yeah, it's just, it's worth it. So the next thing I'm going to talk to you guys about is highlighter. Now, you don't have to use highlighter, it's just purely what I use sometimes. Don't use it all the time, because sometimes it makes me glow up a little bit, and then, you know, I'm luminous and people just know that you're wearing makeup. So I have two types of brushes that I use for highlighter. Now, I love this brush because it kind of reminds me of the brushes we used to have backstage when we were applying all our foundations and stuff. Now, like my foundation, I go for really natural colours. I do not go for really luminous colours, because I just know that people are going to know that I'm wearing foundation, and I don't really care that people know that I'm wearing it, but sometimes it looks a bit more natural, I suppose. I've said natural quite a few times in this video. I do apologise if I say it anymore, because it's kind of like, Miss Vanjie. You know, it's one of those words that I can't get out of my head. So I use Revolution, which you can buy in Superdrug. And I've had this palette for a while. It's one of my favourites because it's probably one of the most naturals you can get. You can actually cater what sort of palettes you want. You can choose it now. I didn't know you could do that, so the next time I buy Revolution, I might do a little haul on this. So I use an angular brush most of the time, and sometimes I mix the colours up a little bit, because like I said, I'm really pale. You can mix up the colours as well. I do that sometimes. It kind of depends what mood I'm in, but all you do is simply apply it from this bone up here, which is your top bit of your cheekbone. And you just smooth it across like so, on the other side as well. It depends really, because you can use this one as well, but this one kind of, you have to be really careful with, just in case it just goes all over the place. And look at that, look at that, look at that. How amazing is that? Now, you can get really good deals with Revolution. I love Revolution. So I've got two here, which I will put up. So this is Blush Golden Sugar, and this is Blush Palette Blush Queen, or King, because we're guys, yeah, masculinity. And then your face is complete. So yeah, I look pretty dolled up, not gonna lie. So yeah, thank you for watching this video. I really hope you enjoyed it and you've got some tips on what to buy. You know, if you're a guy or a girl, you know, you want to try makeup out for the first time, or you know, you just want to expand in your cosmetic empire of products, then go on, my loves, do it. Yeah, thank you for watching this video. There is a like, a share and subscribe button down below, which you're gonna do because it's me. And I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.